I'm frequently asked, how do we develop fears and phobias? I'm Ottmar, and I'm from the School of Psychology at Curtin University. And my research interest is in the psychology of emotion. And how we develop fears and anxiety is one of the research topics that we research. There's currently very good agreement that we learn fears. So we either acquire them by experiencing something negative, we may be bitten by a dog and then become afraid of dogs, or by observing others to have the same experience, or via information. So we may hear that dogs are dangerous and then remember the big black dog that we saw the other day. There's other factors that contribute, because not everybody develops a fear if they are bitten by a dog, for instance. Genetics plays a role. Family background, whether your parents were afraid, plays a role as well. Being anxious, being fearful, is not necessarily something bad. Fear is a very adaptive emotion, and it prevents us from getting into situations that are dangerous for us. People who don't experience fear are at risk of injury or worse. Fear can become problematic if it prevents you from doing things that you would like to do, or if it's inappropriate for the situation. So for instance, if you encounter a snake, to be afraid of snakes makes perfect sense. It will make you either freeze and not move and give the snake an opportunity to slither away, or it will make you run faster. Being afraid of snakes to the extent that you don't leave the house is a bad thing. If you have anxieties that prevent you from doing things that you would want to do, then it's a good idea, it's a good first step to see a counselor or a psychologist. Psychologists are very good at reducing fears, at treating fears, and success rates are very high. However, the problem that they encounter is that relapse also occurs. So fear that's successfully treated may reoccur later on. And that's where our research currently comes into the game. What we are looking at is how we can make the treatments, the interventions that reduce fear, more lasting and more robust. In doing so, we hope to develop new treatments that will prevent relapse from occurring.